Well, Delta Airlines CEO Ed Bastian coming out saying he is completely against the federal jab mandates that Biden put into place. But what's the real story here? What was it that Ed Bastian said about all of his employees that they would have to do even before Biden's announcement? We're going to get into all those details and more, guys, in just a second. First, if you could, please like this video, share it, hit the bell, subscribe, and wear the glasses because I'm blind. Also, if you could, consider making a generous donation here to our ministry as we are demonetized on YouTube. They don't support what we do, but you guys can help us out in a major way. If you enjoy the daily content we put out talking about end time Bible prophecy headlines and our ministry here of getting people to Jesus Christ, you could help out through PayPal or Patreon. Even just $5 a month on Patreon will get you bonus content. Plus, we include the links to the YouTube videos so you get all alerts when new content arrives. Plus, there you can comment censorship-free. You can send me direct messages. It's a great way to stay up to date with all the content that we produce here. Another big reminder, guys, sub to me on Rumble. That's our backup in case we're kicked off of YouTube. We're already posting there, so go check it out. All the links are down below. A big thank you to everybody already contributing. And for those of you thinking of doing so, thank you as well. Your generosity is greatly appreciated. So I found this funny. Ed Bastian, the CEO of Delta Airlines, he goes on Fox Business and he's basically praising himself, patting himself on the back because Delta Airlines never imposed a jab mandate on any of their workers at all. And he said it's because of this that they've been able to get 90% of their staff fully jabbed. He says that's all because they never imposed a mandate. But wait. We need to pump the brakes a second here because they effectively did put a mandate out for the jab. And I'll explain why. It was back in August. Now, mind you, this is 1 month prior to Biden's announcement about the jab mandate for all the federal workers, you know, government contractors, and also for the private businesses, the businesses that have more than 100 employees, that they would be required to take the jab or test negatively each week for the Rona. So in August, Ed Bastian says, you know what, as a way to increase our jab numbers here, percentages, we're going to implement a $200 surcharge, $200 monthly surcharge for our insurance for all employees who say they are not going to get the jab because of the cost that it's having on us here at Delta Airlines for anybody who goes into the hospital because of Rona. $200 extra per month for those employees. And he even admitted it here in this interview with Fox Business that that helped to increase more people getting the jab at the company. Now, with Delta Airlines, employees have until November 1st. This was on Delta. They have to get the jab or have their insurance raise another $200 a month. So you have that date coming up, but then there's the December 8th deadline, which is when Biden and his cronies have said that all the federal workers contractors must have their jabs as well. So really what this means is that, you know, I don't even know, they might have to just wipe out this $200 surcharge thing because they're not going to allow any employee there at Delta to keep their job if they don't have the jab by December the 8th. So that, I don't know, that is that just gonna void out the $200 surcharge for the insurance? Ed Bastian did not say. He just instead complimented himself for the way that Delta Airlines has handled this and saying that they have not in any way endorsed mandates. I don't know how you get away with that. He says, I'm not a fan of these sort of federal mandates or what Biden is doing. I believe in personal choice. You don't believe in personal choice. You don't believe in personal choice at all. Because if you did, you would have never said what you said about the insurance hike. See, everybody thinks they can go blame Biden. That's what they're all doing. Gary Kelly, the CEO of Southwest Airlines, said it earlier in the week as well, saying, I'm not a fan of the mandates. And he blames Biden. But he said he will comply and make sure that everybody on his team is fully jabbed or out of a job by December the 8th, as if Southwest Airlines doesn't have enough problems as it is. We know about all the flight cancellations, all the drama there. And rest assured, this is going to happen with Delta Airlines, United Airlines. Look, all of them are going down, ladies and gentlemen. They just are. Bottom line, You know, we've talked about before, and I've said that I think the federal government is going to put a mandate that anybody traveling, domestic travel in the United States, you will have to have the jab in order to fly. But the way we're going right now, these airlines might be completely crippled before that even happens. They might not have anybody to actually operate the planes or actually work in the airport. Is it just me, or is this just a complete collapse of our entire society? Of the old order? So if the old order collapses, what does that mean? Well, it means a new world order needs to rise up, right? Oh, just like the Bible talks about, right? The Antichrist. It's very prophetic. This is not a coincidence, ladies and gentlemen. It's all part of a grand plan. And everybody is in on it. Not just one country. All. The entire world. Are we in the last days? You better believe we are. Is Jesus Christ coming back soon? You better believe that he is. Will you meet him? Well, that depends on if you've accepted him as your Lord and Savior. If not, we want to lead you in a prayer right now to accept Christ as your Lord and Savior. You can do this prayer in your own words. I'll give you the steps you need to bring that prayer before the Lord. Here's the first thing you want to do, and that's acknowledge that you're a sinner, something that we all are. But God gave his only Son, Jesus Christ, to die on that cross for the sins of all the world. He died and rose again for you. That's the good news. You have to believe that in your heart, that he died and rose again for you. And then you have to repent of your sin. Repent means to turn from your sin, not just to say you're sorry, but to turn from lifestyles, habits, whatever it is in your life that goes against the word of God. You ask Jesus to forgive you. He'll wipe that sin away. The Bible says he won't remember it any longer. And then you invite Jesus into your life to be your Lord and Savior. When you do that, you become born again, a child of God. You will have eternal life. Trust me when I tell you, there is no greater decision that you will ever make than the one you do to give your life to Christ. I pray you make that decision today. I'll have more for you guys on this down below. You can let me know your thoughts. Don't forget the links to donate to our ministry are there as well. It is a great blessing if you could help us out. Thank you all so much for watching. I really do appreciate it. I'll be back with more. You guys take care. Please be safe out there. God bless each and every single one of you, and I'll talk with you soon.